Yo, Spartan Red, greetings, and welcome back. How are you doing? I hope your day has been blessed. Big shout out to the Eagle Eye crew and all male soldiers out there researching and trying to bring the truth. Well, just doing a little review on the Red Brick Secrets stream from last night. Showing just quickly going through the evidence that I showed. I always find it helpful to do a review. People don't, sometimes they don't want to watch all of the stream, or they can't watch all of the stream. So, a quick little video just to show what I showed. Also, I like doing them. I do like doing them. Big shout out also to the MVPs, James, Marcus Aurelius, and Dino. Hopefully, Dino will be in the chill out zone tonight. He wasn't in yesterday. Hope you're okay, mate. Likewise, a big shout out to Jed, Ivaldes, Joachim. Knowledge. Peeking through the veil, connecting the dots, Tobias, Alchemist 83, Tara, Deb, the Red Brick Chick. I'm so glad you've been sorted out now, Deb, so hopefully we'll see you back in the chill out zone soon, devastating everybody with that evidence that we know you've got. A very, very fantastic researcher is Deborah, and she wears that moniker, Red Brick Chick, with pride. Tell ya, she's hardcore. Love her to bits. Likewise, a shout out to Patty, a new eagle in the Eagle Eye crew, but she is putting boots on the ground. Videos out already. Incredible, absolutely incredible. We are growing at such a rate. We are waking people up. We are doing what we're supposed to be doing. It is great. I feel so humble. Yeah, I do, especially when you got stories like Patty, who just went out into her garden and went into her basement and found the evidence right there in her own home, in her own backyard. Crazy, absolutely crazy. So, long may it continue, long may it continue. Before I say anything, I'd like to subscribe, make sure you tell your friends, get them onto Red Bricks, get them into the group. We need more feet on the Red Brick Road. Again, I will put all the links for those channels in the description box. Likewise, if you want to get hold of me or come on the show, on the screen, my email and my Instagram will be in the description box also. And also, if you want to catch all my old videos, my old stuff, my Baby Spartan, Big Humble Beginnings, all those videos on Odyssey, that link is in the description box as well. And include if you want to make a donation to the channel. The PayPal link is in the description box, and you can have first-hand testimony from Deborah what we're doing with the money. So every penny counts, every dollar counts, every 5 quid counts. So if you can spare a few, let's have it. We will be so happy to help the next person out. Anyway, that's those links. So I know you've like, there's no memes, so don't even think about it. Oh, was a meme Spartan? No, I don't do memes. I only do memes in the chill out zone for a reason. Got to keep you guys hungry. Hungry for memes. Oh yeah, there's psychology behind this. Even though I'm a mental midget, there's still psychology behind it. You know, I love it when people underestimate me. I love that. I actually really do like that. It gives me motivation, you see. Oh, well, anyway, we weren't talking about that sort of thing. Don't need it. You don't need no negative vibes. It's only positive vibes that I'm dealing with. Positive vibe people as well. It just makes things so, so much easier. That's why I love the Eagle Eye crew. All positive vibe people, you know. And, you know, even if you're in a different camp, or you think you're in a different camp, you're not. You're in the Meltology camp. You're in the Meltology camp. It's just that we're doing it in a slightly different way. Well, not even a slightly different way, we're just doing it a totally different way, you know. We want to be more inclusive, we want more people in, and you can't be that if you're hostile. Anyway, let us get into this. Let's get start getting into these. I showed these last. I won't talk through too much. I don't need to, because all you got eyes to see. All you got eyes to see. I just might even just go like this and just let it just flick through, because I don't really want to be zooming and all this shit. Don't need to. You all got eyes. You all can see what's on here. Say it's just a review. I mean, I could even flick them on myself, you know, I mean, damage to these apertures, these windows, the archway. I'm not dilly dallying. I've still got evidence to get for tonight. I haven't got enough yet. You know me, guys. I like to bring plenty of evidence, and you know. You never know who's going to be showing evidence and who won't be, you know. So I always have to have plenty of evidence to show you guys. Look at the balloon rocks here. Corner needs funnel blocking. Crazy. It's all damaged here. So, wow. We'll carry on zooming and moving, shrooming and zooming, as they say. Tetris God here. Look. Small bricks here. Blocks here. Huge block here. Mad. Just don't build like that, I'm afraid. Yeah, I like a bit of Bob in dub. I love it. Look at that melt behind. Incredible. It's erosion. Erosion, they tell you. A bit of bobbing dub. You see, that was a gun emplacement. Now they put a gun, a big fucking battery gun there in the top. This is in Spain, I believe. Spain. You see the back of it here. Look, this is a huge fucking gun they've emplaced here. They can't explain this shit here, though. They can't explain the damage to this building. I just had to nip for a drink. It's so thirsty. I can't believe how thirsty you get to be fucking chatting all the time. Yeah, I know. I need to get a new lighter. Fuck this. But you know what? I don't need a new lighter. I need to put another flint in there. I can't believe how quickly the flints run out in these bastards. And I'm forever topping it up with fucking gas. That's how much I smoke. So no, I need to cut down. Look, harp. Harp, look at the clouds, harp. Red brick damage. Ooh, Dracula's castle. Look at that. The brick flood underneath. Wow, brick ash.
Okay.
again, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit your notification bell, because I'm liable to stream at any time when the mood hits me. And I'll definitely be streaming Sunday, so make sure your notifications bells are up. I probably won't stream the same time as Knowledge again. That was a bit too much for people. That didn't, you had to have two phones. Like James, he had two phones on. One of them, me on one, and Knowledge on the other. So I'm going to try and work it out. So it'll probably be the Big Easy. It may start about 3 o'clock UK time, and then I'll probably stay on for about an hour and a half on YouTube, and then we'll have part two in the chill out zone in the evening. But it's good to have all these media platforms that we can go on. It's great. I love it. I mean, I'm just so pleased for James as well, because everybody else has got their own little thing now on the Chill Out Zone, and I was waiting to see if James was going to react, and if he was going to want to do something, and he has reacted, and he does want to do stuff, and he does want to have his stream, his night. So his first one was great. I thought he did wonderfully well, and he'll only grow into it as he does more and more. So it's a wonderful thing to see these guys starting to really evolve in Meltology, and be confident to come and run a stream and have their own take on things and run it their own way, which is all that I ever wanted. As I say, and I keep saying it, don't be shocked one day Spartan won't be streaming no more on StreamYard the way he's doing it. I may do keep streaming on YouTube, doing the lives on YouTube, but I won't be in the chill out zone. I'll be in the back, technical director in the back. And it's for various reasons, not many people know the reasons, but it's for various reasons. Anyone who knows me well will know that I never really wanted to be front of house. I never wanted to be the one in front of the camera. I never, I'd rather be the research guy, get the pictures and stuff like that. But, necessity sometimes, you have to step up. And the group needed to be created. We needed an outlet there, because the one that was going on at the time was stalled. You couldn't use it, so we needed a group, and we also needed a stream that was consistently precise, and you could bank on it being on every day and not having any problems. Yes, we've had problems, of course, but all streams do. But what I'm talking about is having a stream where it's conducive to people wanting to come in and relax, and not have all that kind of madness going on. You're investing your time to come to the stream. Let's make it a place where you want to come back and invest your time again and again. That's the thinking behind the chill out zone. And obviously, we want people to feel inclusive in everything we do. You're not an outsider. No one is. We're all here to learn. When you come in, when you started growing as a baby, you didn't just spring on your feet and start running the 100 metres. And most people learn at different rates. Some people pick it up straight away, like I did. I picked it up straight away. It was no far stretch of the imagination to start understanding Meltology for me. Because I believe my eyes, and I've never believed mainstream, the mainstream educational system is basically inherently flawed. So it's very easy for me to understand what I was seeing and to find the evidence of what I was seeing again and again and again. But some people, they take a little while longer, and that as a human being, you have to have patience with people as well if you're trying to be inclusive. You're trying to make this Meltology expand. You're trying to bring it into the public awareness. You can't be divisive. You can't be violent. You can't be abusive. I always believe that there's there's always two ways to skin a cat, but the easiest way is to give it a stroke and make it your friend. That's what I believe, but you know, some people, you know, they're going about it a different way. And also, you, with this kind of truth, you have to be humble. And with humility, you can put yourself in the other guy's shoes. If you're too far up your arse, ego driven, you can never put yourself in the other guy's shoes, because you know you're thinking everyone should be on your level. But you know what? You should bring your message down to their level so they can understand it in a way where they can start expanding their mind and start teaching themselves. It's all about community for me. Community and good connections with people. I hope it comes across. I'm a love guy. I love everybody. Until you give me a reason not to. And then I just give you distance. Simple, I give you distance. I don't have arguments with people. I don't have drama with people. I just give them distance. You start being off key with me, I'll just give you distance, mate. Go away. I ain't got nothing to say to you after that. You know? I just think that some people are just so caught up in their own selves, they can't see the wood for the trees. But that's just my take on things. But as I say, we don't seem to have that kind of problem with in the Eagle Eye crew. Everybody's on the same level, everybody's learning, everybody's trying to teach, everybody's trying to bring the right awareness, bring the love frequency up. At the moment, the Chillax Zone is a great place to be. As I say, people are trying to imitate it now. I'm not mentioning no names, but people are trying to imitate what we're doing now. Considering we were mental midgets a few months ago, it's nice to watch that happen. It is bloody nice to watch it happen. But hey ho, as I say, we don't worry about what's behind. We're too busy looking in front. You know, that's why eagles are so good at flying, because they always concentrate on what's in front. And we do fly high, and we do fly straight, and we do fly together. You know, this is why we're so good, because we're a collective. We've got people all over the realm. Boots on the ground, avid researchers, video, drone footage, we've got people everywhere. Once everybody gets into the flow, and you know, these travel restrictions start to rescind, and we can start moving out properly, it's going to be great. I mean, I'm supposed to be going up to Oxford soon to do some boots on the ground in Oxford, and I can't wait to do it, because Oxford is just one of them places full of old world order buildings. Grid component, powers to the domes everywhere, circuit board component. Use your mono a bit, because I can't stand on ceremony, I've still got work to do. This is like having a break. Putting the video together. It is. Back to the wall here. Look at it. Tourists are going in. Back. This place is just totally fried. This is just totally fried. Look at it. These are brick fries. Separate, not like coral now. Incredible now. Yeah. see it everywhere. It's consistent. It's heat rising from the bottom, coming from the bottom, making the bricks balloon rock and climb up the sides and doing this to buildings. Look. Look. Oh my. How did they do that? How did they build there? I mean, it's, look at this shit here. This is meltology. Look at it. Oh man. Please. Bricks here. Apertures everywhere. Buildings melting like butter. Bada 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 bada. All you're seeing is the tops of melted buildings. This is lucky it's got fragments and pockets of survival. This hasn't, but it flooded this. Oh man. Come on. You can't build, put buildings like that on top of mountains. Doesn't work. Doesn't work, Garth. Doesn't work. Red bricks. Red, 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 red bricks. Right down here. And huge building melted. See the brick lines. These are brick lines. Huge block lines. And this is the pocket survival on the A-frame. The evidence is all around you. I remember a program I used to watch called The World About Us, BBC wildlife kind of program. This is the world around you, the melt. That is your world, melt. Please see it. Pocket of survival. Huge melting building behind. Pieces of melt. Absolute bricks here. Side of this. Look what's happening here. What's happening here? Flooded inside, but the balloon rocks is attached to the side. It's fried, melted down. All this is brick flood out here in this building. So I'm just zooming for a quick glimpse. If you want to see them properly and the gasp of astonishment from the guys in the studio, you have to watch the stream. Yeah, look, see, look at this huge balloon rock attached. This is all red bricks, expanded out. And here, and here, and here. This one fell off. And of course, we keep saying it all the time. Mountains are nothing more than melted buildings. Here's Montezuma's castle, how'd they put that up there? End of story. Look at the apertures here. The arse of this is melting outwards, look, melting downwards. This is melt densified. It's flowing like water. And then densified as it's the electrical charge. And the heat dissipated. You're getting it now? You're seeing it now? You're feeling it now? Because when I see these pictures, I feel it. Just go back. Look at this shit here. Blocks, bricks. Metamorphosis. Metamorphosing right here. From bricks to this madness. Brick component melting down was easy. Terracing down. Look at this corner. Balloon rocked out. Balloon rocked out here. The buildings exploded. The buildings fried. The bricks fried. This is what happened to them. Just like popcorn kernels pop, bricks pop as well. Look at them melt. Look, all over the steps. Clearly from here. Can't be from nowhere else. Everywhere, even out here, to the bottom here of this tower, and a huge mound. In his life, in his life, in his life, in his life. Yeah, so guys, that's the end of that. I hope you enjoyed that, this little video. It's just a little review of what was shown on Wednesday night. Please come back, please watch out for the videos and the live streams. We've got so many people up going out live at the moment, it's unreal. I'll get off this video of someone's life, so it's all good. But please, remember, we are the survivors of the survivors. Take care of yourselves and take care of one another. It's vitally, vitally important in these dark times. I'll be back with some more flavour real soon. Watch out for the live stream tonight and tomorrow night, and hopefully I'll see you on the weekend in the Big Easy, the Sunday Easy. I'm not sure what time I'm going to stream it, so watch out, get your notification bells on. Oh, like, share, subscribe, share the link. Love you all, take care, bring love, spark red.